It's day four, and we're up for some real excitement today. Because, you see, yesterday I learned that I can teach the computer to make decisions for me. Honestly, choosing a proper outfit is serious business. Every morning I think, alright, I can come to work in anything. Skinny jeans, shiny things, colors, hats, whatever. But then I think if I come to work in a pirate costume, it's just going to be covered up by a white lab coat anyways. So, too much thought. Time to automate. So, let's be a little devious. Skip today's programming lesson and make something cool. I've been thinking about it, and to make this thing, I think I'll need to learn a special phrase in Quorum called repeat. Apparently, this phrase is how you tell the computer to do something over and over again in a block of code, which means I'll probably have to tell the computer where the code block ends. Let's type those things first. So, repeat, enter, and end. These repeat things come in different styles, just like my outfits. I'm not totally sure how that works, though. I would ask Paul, but he isn't in again today. Maybe I should call him.
Hello?
Hey, Paul, this is Mary. Are you okay? Where are you?
I'm in the hospital. The doctors tell me I've been eating too much junk, but they can't actually find anything wrong. It might be an infection or something.
Sorry to hear that. Not to be insensitive, but can I ask you a programming question?
I guess.
So, I'm working on this, genetics algorithm, and I was wondering what kind of repeat thingy I should use.
Oh, well, any of them are fine, but I usually use repeat times. You pass an integer in between the two words.
Integer?
It's a positive or negative whole number, so like, no decimal point.
Oh, got it. So, repeat 10 times?
Intuitive, right?
Yeah, that seems easy. Thanks, and feel better.
Thanks.
Alright, I think we should start by having it repeat 5 times, one for each day of the work week. First, I'm going to try that while outputting a word to make sure that it works. So, repeat 5 times, output double quotes, outfit double quotes, and end. Now let's run it. And we got outfit 5 times. That works, but if I want to make a choice of outfit for each day, I'll need to keep a track of what day it is. Maybe we can use an integer to represent which day of the week we're at, and then make the number go up by 1 each time we repeat. Let's remove what we have so far and just create this new loop from scratch. So the first thing we would want to do is set our day variable to 1 outside of the repeat block. Otherwise, we would keep resetting it back to 1 each time the loop ran, and that wouldn't do us any good. So let's put integer day equals 1. Next, we'll start our repeat statement by putting repeat 5 times. And then we'll tell the computer to output whatever's in the day variable by typing output day. Since we want the number in the day variable to go up each time, we'll just add 1 to it whenever it repeats with the phrase day equals day plus 1. Last but not least, we need to end the repeat block and then run it. Looks like it counted from 1 to 5, which is what I was hoping for it to do, but how the heck do I figure out how to make it choose my clothing for a given day? It looks like it's 1:48 on a Friday. I'm gonna leave early and finish this up over the weekend.